My aim for this talk is to introduce to your audience the fundamentals of Lie algebra so that this topic becomes somewhat familiar to you. So I am assuming that all the participants, although I can't see them here, but all the participants are well versed with vector spaces, rings, fields, and a part of modules over rings with identity. So with this much background, let me introduce you to an algebra. So the definition goes like this, that a non-associative algebra A over a field F is a vector space in which a bilinear composition is defined. That is for all alpha in the field and x1, x2, y1, y2, xy in A, these distributive laws, and this alpha xy is same as alpha xy is same as x alpha y. So alpha can move around. XY belongs to A. For XY in A, XY also belongs to A. So if A is a finite dimensional algebra, and suppose the dimension is N and it has a basis E1, E2, EN, then we can then EI, EJ also belongs to A and therefore can also be expressed as a linear combination of its basis elements. So I'm expressing each EI, EJ, this product, as a linear combination of the basis elements. So this is K equal to 1 to N, gamma IJ, K, EK. Now these constants, gamma IJ, K, these are N cube in number, okay? Each I, J, K vary from 1 to N. So these are N cube in number and are called the structure constants or the constants of multiplication of our algebra A with respect to the given basis. One can see that if X and Y belongs to A and X is X, I, I, E, I runs from 1 to N, and similarly Y is eta, J, E, J. Eta j is in the field, then x into y, x product y is this, which I can express like this, and then this is I j k equal to 1 to n, this. So these gamma I j k determine every product in A. A non-associative algebra is said to be associative if the product also satisfies the associative property. So if xyz is equal to x of yz, for every xyz in A, then the algebra A is called associative. Further, a non-associative algebra L is called a Lie algebra if for all x, y, z in L, these two conditions are satisfied. One is that x square is zero, and the second property is Jacobi identity, and it goes like this, that x, y, z plus y, z, x plus z, x, y is zero. So if these two properties are satisfied, then a non-associative algebra L is called a Lie algebra. The first property, x square equal to 0, can be replaced by that the product xy is same as minus of yx, provided characteristic of f is not 2. Okay, this can be checked easily, that if because it's x square is 0 for every x in L, so x plus y square is also 0, which will give me xy plus yx equal to 0, and that is equal to xy equal to minus yx. And if xy is equal to minus yx, converse, I am telling you. Then for x equal to y, this will be x square is equal to minus x square, which is 2x square equal to 0. And if characteristic of f is not 2, then it means that x square is 0. So if the field is not of characteristic 2, then I can replace the first property by that the product xy is minus yx. Now, one can generate a Lie algebra from a given associative algebra. So I am showing the process here that let A be an associative algebra, and for x, y in A, we are defining a new product which we are calling as commutator or Lie product by that x into y is xy minus yx. So first we will check that whether with this product you have an algebra or not, and a non-associative algebra or not. So the product of x1 plus x2y, just it requires some computation. You will have x1 plus x2y minus y times x1 plus x2. Now this product, x into y, is already associative, and all those conditions are satisfied, which lead to that this is equal to x1y plus x2y. And similarly, x with y1 plus y2 again will be x y1 plus y2 minus y1 plus y2 times x. And then you will combine the terms x y1 minus y1x, which give me x y1. And then x y2 minus y2x, which will give me the commutator of x and y2. And this property can also be checked at alpha of xy, that is alpha xy minus yx. And this can be rearranged using this third property. Okay, it can be rearranged using the third property that it is alpha x of y and x of alpha y. Now we need to check these two properties, x square equal to 0 and this. This x square equal to 0 is trivial, because if you put y equal to x, this is x square minus x square, which is 0. Now how to check this Jacobi identity? You have that this x, y, z plus y, z, x plus z, x, y for because this is the first such computation. So I am giving the details that this is the commutator of x, y with z. So the x, y is x, y minus y, x. And so this with z, it means that x, y minus y, x, z minus z, x, y minus y, x, and two more commutators opened like this. The third, the last term is not visible, and that is minus y zx minus xz. Now look here, this xyz